Minor League Baseball is live and on the air on the show. It's a big one. Game three between the Scranton-Wilkes-Barre Rail Riders and the Durham Bulls. So coming to the plate, Ben Ruda, and we are set for baseball here this evening. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. A bouncer to the left side. And there's one gone to begin the evening. Digging in the switch hitter, Rossel Herrera will swing it from the left side right here.
More of a comfortable side from the left side. Puts the ball in play, more of a contact hitter from the left side. Might have grown up being a natural left-handed hitter.
Two balls and a strike now. Now the 2-1. There's a fastball taken high for a ball. One out, nobody on. Hit hard back up the middle. Scooped up. And the throw here is going to get him at first. Excellent range there at short, and there are two away now. To the plate now is the designated hitter, Clint Frazier. First chance for him here in the top of the first with nobody on. A ball and two strikes, the count now with the bases empty and two away. And he'll try to take control of the inside part of the plate here as that misses. Here now the 2-2. Nobody on. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And good patience to hold back on the curveball in the dirt. It's full now, 3-2.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count.
And the throw to first is there. The inning is over. So digging in now, Randy Arozarena. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Set to deliver on 2-1. Hit down the third baseline, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. The pitch. And a big cut at the breaking ball, but he comes up empty, and that's the first out. In now, Greg Jones. And he chased it in the dirt. Deglin goes to get it, and the throw to first is there to record the second out. Kevin Smith will be next, looking to get on base and keep this first inning alive. Still hanging with him, another good swing to keep it going. This one misses, and that'll fill the count here. 3-2 with two away.
You can bet these hitters are taking note of what the guy on the hill is working with.
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Now in the box, Brandon Wagner. He'll get us started in the top of the second. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. This is on the ground over to first, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Coming to the plate now, Jason Dominguez, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here. Ready to deal, here's the 1-1. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Long run for the right fielder. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning. Stepping into the box, Kellen Deglin. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. The 1-1 home.
Yep, that ball went out.
Ah. in there, and it's even now, 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Ground ball foul down the left side. The next 3-2. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. Padlo has got it, and the side is retired. Bottom of the inning now, and next it'll be the outfielder, Dylan Cousins. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And a curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now, 1-2. Coming down in buckets, cats and dogs, insert metaphor here, and the forecast is not showing any signs of relief.
You know, one of the big issues is player safety, and right now this field is getting sloppy wet, Matt, and I don't know how much more rain this field can take.
A swing and a miss on a ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. 2-2. Gets him looking up around the letters. Now batting, Kevin Padlo. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better. Tough curveball that time, but he's able to make a little contact to keep this at bat going. Well, you don't need us to tell you, it's really starting to come down out there. I can't imagine the umpires will let this go too much longer if it doesn't ease up.
Well, you could say that again, Matt. It's raining cats and dogs out there. Make sure you don't step in a poodle. I think it's time to get the grounds crew out.
And here's a curveball that's laid off that time. It's full, 3-2. And my goodness, how about this? He struck out the side in back-to-back innings, 6 in a row, and the inning is over. Coming to the plate now, Kyle Holder, 7-8-9, bottom of the order set to go here in the third. Slow little roller to third. He's got it. Off balance throw, but he couldn't get enough on it, so it'll be scored as an infield single.
Batting it, the third baseman, number 3.
To the plate now, Mandy Alvarez. Strike taken, the throw. Ball's there, and he is out. Good throw. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. A swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third. Now to the plate, Caleb Cower, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike 3 called, and the inning is over. Bottom of the third now, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Dalton Kelly. Now the 1-1 pitch. He's in there for strike number 2. Started to chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball 2. Two pitch is fouled away. Pitch on the way. Popped him up. And he'll stay with it here as he puts the squeeze on it for out number 1. Stepping in, Lucius Fox. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Bottom of inning number 3, 0-0 our score. Took a good cut that time. It comes up empty, 2-2.
Good luck with that pitch. That pitch is an absolute nightmare, almost unhittable. Nasty downward action, high 80s velocity.
Vidal Brujan is on deck, and he fouls this one off. The next 3-2. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. It gets down, and that'll be extra bases on their first hit of the game. And he's in there at third with a one-out triple. Standing in now, Vidal Rujan. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball. A little too tall that time. 3-1 now.
Props to the hitter right there for laying off with a guy on third. You want to be aggressive, but you have to get a pitch you can drive.
3-2, full count. He's ready. Now the payoff pitch. Bouncer up the middle. And that's through into center field. Base hit. The runner from third crosses the plate, and they've taken a 1-0 lead. Now a move over to first, and he'll dive back in. So now to the plate, Randy Arozarena checks his swing here, but he does so in time. Throw over to first, and he'll get back in safely. And another throw over, and he just manages to get his hand in. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Ruda is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Digging in for his second at bat, Greg Jones, 0-for-1 here in the early going. Rujan is off of first with two away, and a dive, but he's back in there. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Dominguez will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Into the box now, Ben Ruda. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 1-1 home. Taken, strike two. No offer at the curve that time, and it's knotted up at 2-2. Pitch on the way. Won't commit on the slider. Good patience, and it's full. 3-2.
Great AB up until this point. A walk right here could really just infuse some confidence into this lineup.
And that'll get down for a base hit. Stepping in now, Rossell Herrera. And he's a little too high with that one. Two balls and a strike. 2-2.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
3-2 now.
Gotta believe that runner from first is going to be in motion, especially in this situation. As an offensive player, just hit something hard because those defenders are going to be moving.
Cousins will settle under it to make the play for the first out as the runner will have to head back to first. So a runner at first with one man gone, and that'll bring up the outfielder Clint Frazier. Here's the 1-1. Hard hit at third. Oh, what a stop on the slide. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And next to hit is the catcher, Kevin Smith. Here now the 2-2. Gets him looking. Strike three. Now at the plate, Dylan Cousins comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. The 1-1 home. Grounded down the third baseline. A dive, but he can't make the play, and it's down the left field line. In now, Brian O'Grady on a line to shortstop, but the runner is back to avoid the double play. Into the box, Kevin Padlo. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Two balls and two strikes now. Swung on and chopped to third. Throw in time and the side is retired. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And here comes the first baseman, Brandon Wagner. And the 2-1. That's lifted the other way out to left. O'Grady is right there as he puts it away. No problem for the first down. Digging in, Jason Dominguez. He flew out in his last at bat. The 1-1 home. Ground ball foul down the left side. The 1-2. Grounded to short. Reined in. And there's out number two. At the plate, Kellen Deglin. He popped out in his first trip. Bases are empty here with two men out. And a fastball misses there. Ball four. Striding into the box, Kyle Holder. Man at first after the two-out walk.
Holder.
Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Call didn't go his way on 2-1, but it's important here on 3-1 to still make a quality pitch. You have to have the mindset that you're still the one in the driver's seat.
And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. Now at the plate, Dalton Kelly, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. One and two now as that one's fouled off. Now the pitch. Count still at 1-2. Now here's the pitch.
That's a ball.
Only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at bat.
Now batting,
digging in to try it again, Lucius Fox. He smacked a triple and later scored his first time around. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. Into right field, that's a base hit. Plate now, Vidal Brujan fouled off. A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch. Grounded up the first baseline, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. From the belt, the pitch struck him out, and he becomes the 9th strikeout victim thus far. Standing in, Randy Arozarena. He struck out and flied out, 0-for-2 so far. Keeping it down here as it's to 1-2.
Not too many guys taking a mound today with this good a split. Look at the downward action on that thing. It's falling off the table.
A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit. And that runner will go no further than second as there are two aboard now. Into the box now, Greg Jones. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
The 3-1 pitch. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul. So a missed opportunity there. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. The payoff pitch. And this ball is popped up, drifting back behind the mound. And the two-out threat will not come to pass as the inning is over. Top half of the sixth about to get started. And set to go is the third baseman, Mandy Alvarez. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Pulls this one in the air out to left. O'Grady is there, and he makes the catch for the out. Here's Caleb Cowart. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Caleb.
Bases are empty, one man out. And there's ball two now. Popped him up. Padlo in foul ground. But this will land untouched. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Here now the 2-2.
You could pretty much book it that a fastball's coming. A challenge fastball right here. He cannot allow the nine-hole hitter to get on base with the top of the order looming.
Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat. Stepping into the box, Ben Ruda. A hit and two tries for him so far. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Grounded softly to the right. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Luis Sessa enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Number 85.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and now it'll be the catcher, Kevin Smith. Back up the middle. And this will find its way into center field for a leadoff single. Standing in now, Dylan Cousins. Outside in a full count, 3-2. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out. Now at the plate, Brian O'Grady. He's 0-for-2 with a strikeout in this one. The 1-2. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Pereira is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Ready now, Kevin Padlo. 0-for-2 for him to this point. Full count now.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Hit hard down the line. A diving try at third, but this is by him, a fair ball. Throw comes in quickly from left, so even on the hit and run, they'll hold things to first and second here. Into the box, Dalton Kelly. And he lays off the pitch down and away. Ball two. This is flared out towards second. They'll whip this one first in time, and that ends the inning. Riding in, Rossel Herrera. He'll start the seventh in what's been a fast-moving pitcher's duel to date. The 1-1. Hard ground ball to third. And that's through into left, so a leadoff single here to start the seventh. So now to the plate, Clint Frazier. And he misses 2-1.
Sitting in a good spot right here. 2-1 count is yet to see a fastball. Have to be sitting on one right here.
Here now the 2-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Cousins has the best view of this one, so he'll take it for the first down. Sean Gilmartin comes on to pitch here with one man gone in the top of the seventh.
Brandon Wagner.
Brandon Wagner will be the first to greet him here as he'll stand in with a runner at first and one away. Popped him up. Padlo over to his right. And he makes the catch for the second out. Digging in, Jason Dominguez. He got on top of one and was a ground down victim last time.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes.
Well, the play's been made, and that retires the sun. Dan Otero gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 36. Dan.
Stepping in, Lucius Fox. Two hits and two trips for him thus far. The 3-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. And there's a base hit, so a chance for some insurance here to start out the home half of the seventh. And he'll get in there safely. To the plate now, Vidal Brujan. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. Otero was known as a short relief specialist, a guy who came in, got one or two big outs, but with the new pace of play rules, they're forcing a change for this right-hander. And that's out number one. So the batting order turns over now and set to go. Randy Arozarena, last time through, was a base hit. 2-2, here it is. And he'll try to hold back, but he won't be able to, as that's ruled a swing, and there are two away now.
The batter, number two.
Digging in once again, Greg Jones, runner in scoring position with Sugano. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. On the ground to the right side. Oh, look at the sliding stop. Touché, sir. Andrew Kittredge has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 35.
Stepping up to the plate, Kellen Deglin. It was a walk in his last trip.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
The 1-2 misses for the second ball.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second, just because he took the first one, that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number eight. At the plate, Kyle Holder. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far.
Holder.
The 1-1 home. Hit hard down the left field line. And that is off the wall, but in foul territory. Foul ball.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
The next 1-2 pitch. And this is swung on and missed. Two are quickly retired to start inning number eight. Settling in now, Mandy Alvarez. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. The 1-2 is taken for ball two.
Hey, that's a nice take by the batter right there, but that's a non-competitive off-speed pitch. Got to do better to at least entice a swing.
Filthy changeup that time, but he's able to make contact, and he'll get another chance. Hot shot on the ground is short. Scooped up. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Williams is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 15, Tyler.
Ready for another shot now, Kevin Smith. He steps in off a base hit in his last at bat. The 1-1 home. Grounded to first. He's got it. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
Now batter.
So here's the cleanup hitter, Dylan Cousins. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Ready once again, Brian O'Grady. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. Got him on the good slider there. Swung on and missed as he's down on strikes for the second time tonight. Aaron Loop comes on from the pen, hoping to finish this one off here in the top of the ninth. New inning set to get underway, and set to go is the second baseman, Caleb Power. One and one, here it is. Loop, a left-hander standing just under 6 feet at 5'11". He's got a sinker, a changeup, a two-seamer, a slider, and a cutter. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. And a left-handed batter waiting on deck, though there's a good shot he might get pulled back. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Bounce towards the mound. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway. Standing in, Ben Ruda. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. One-run game here in the top of the ninth. He pulls this one into right. And that ball gets down out near the wall and should be extra bases. And there's your tying run at second base with a one-out double.
The right field is a Rogel Herrera.
At the plate now, Rogel Herrera. Swinging a liner toward the gap in left center. And he is going to tie this ball game late as this ball is down for extra bases. The relay throw, and he'll make it to third base safely with only one out as the go-ahead run. And now, Clint Frazier. Nope. Tough pitch to lay off there, but he did, and it's even up at 2-2.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter.
Coming in to score as the runner from third, and in the late stages of game three, that has broken the tie. Jalen Beeks enters the game with one gone in the top of inning number 9. At the plate, Brandon Wagner. Strike taken up in the zone. Skied into straightaway right. Cousins is there, two down. Ready for another chance, Jason Dominguez. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. And he comes back with a fastball, 1-2 now. Now about a 58-foot breaking pitch that he wisely lays off here.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball. Put himself right back in this at bat.
Hit hard back up the middle. And that's in there. Base hit. Stepping in now, Kellen Degler. And he takes a called strike two.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Count even at 2-2. And it's fouled away. Looks at a fastball low here, and it's full 3-2.
Well, no doubt in my mind, this has been the at-bat of the night so far.
And he misses with it for ball four, so the bases will be loaded now with two away. Into the box now, Kyle Holder, eighth batter of the inning now with the bases loaded and two away. Hard liner to center field. And he will deliver one of the biggest at-bats of the night. It's a base hit. And they're not going to get him as he's in there to score.
The third baseman, number three, Mandy.
Into the box, Mandy Alvarez. Fouled away. And another foul ball. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Tried to get him with the cutter, but it's a full count, 3-2. Ground ball, left side. Reined in. On to first, and it's in time as they're finally able to retire him. Luis Avila is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth. At the plate, Kevin Padlo. Now the 2-1. And that misses there, so he runs the count full now. Dalton Kelly is on deck. Into the corner and slicing foul. And could this be the start? It's a long way back, but the leadoff man is on base to start their final set of at-bats. The 1-1 pitch. Fly ball out to straightaway left. Left fielder is on the move. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. Digging in and looking for more, Lucius Fox. And he'll complete the cycle if he can blast one over the wall here. Weak grounder back to the mound. Oh, and a look what I found out there on the mound. To second for one, on to first, but not in time as he beats it out. Runner on first with two away. Ball two. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Has him down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Hey, baseball players have never been shy about celebrating, but these guys have a lot of work to do, and they know that. They're now out of the first round, but they need to stay focused moving forward if they're going to win the minor league championship.
So we witnessed a close one here, but this man was a big factor in the outcome, so we're inclined to pencil him in as the Topps player of the game.
Yeah, he came through with a multi-hit game, and more importantly, they were big hits. He was a key contributor to the outcome of this one.
for the Rail Riders. 4 runs on 8 hits. No error. They left 5 men on base. For the Bulls.